Hello and welcome in my lecture. This is Barkha Gupta, Associate Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Modi Institute of Technology, Kota. I'm taking a lecture on gears, which provide you a brief introduction of gear. This belongs to Theory of Machine subject for BTech second year, fourth semester course. Moving towards the content, we start with introduction, then we will discuss about classification of gears, in which we have brief introduction of spur gear, helical gear, bevel gear, worm and worm gear. Then we, at the end, we will discuss about gear terminology. So start with the introduction. Gears are toothed wheel which transmit the power from one shaft to another by direct contact. The contact between them is without slipping. That's why they are known as positive drive. They are having line and point contact between them, so making a higher pair. They provide a definite velocity ratio. Classification of gear. There are three criteria to classify the gears. Let us discuss them one by one. First is according to the position of axis of shaft. When the axis of two shafts are parallel, then it is classified as spur gear, helical gear, and rack and pinion. When the axis of two shafts are intersecting, then the gears are bevel gear. And when the axis of shaft is non-intersecting and non-parallel, means they are non-coplanar, then it is worm and worm wheel or skew bevel gear. The another classification is according to peripheral velocity of the gears, in which we have low velocity gear where the velocity is less than 3 meter per second, medium velocity gear where the velocity is in between 3 meter per second to 15 meter per second, and high velocity gear have the velocity is greater than 15 meter per second. The next classification is according to type of gearing, in which external gearing where two gear mesh externally and their motion is unlike, means if one gear rotate in clockwise direction, then other will be in anti-clockwise direction. Internal gearing, when gear meshes internally and having like motion, means both the gears are rotating into the same direction. Rack and pinion, when gear mesh on straight line, means the wheel having infinite radius. Spur gear. These are the simplest type of gear in which teeth are parallel to the shaft axis. They are easy to manufacture and most widely used. Helical gear. In this type of gear, teeth are cut at an angle with shaft axis. Thus, they provide a smooth and gradual engagement with them and run quietly as compared to the spur gear. One more is double helical gear, which is also known as herringbone gear. Bevel gear. This is used for intersecting shaft. The faces of gears are conically shaped. When two equal bevel gears are mounted on two mutually perpendicular shafts, then they are known as meter gear. Worm and worm gears. These are used on non-coplanar shaft and used for higher gear ratios. In this gear, the direction of transmission is not reversible. Example of this gear is wiper motors. The figure shows the meshing of above mentioned gear. In this figure, there is an external mating of spur gear. There is an internal mating of spur gear. The rack and pinion arrangement, helical gears mating, herringbone gear, bevel gear, worm and worm gear, and the meter gear. Now come to the gear terminology. Figure shows the mating of two imaginary friction disc or cylinder which transmit the motion as the pair of gear transmit the pair rolling. These cylinders are known as pitch cylinders. Pitch circles. It is the circle corresponding to the pitch cylinder when it is sectioned by a plane which is normal to its axis. Pitch diameter. It is the diameter of pitch circle. Pitch surface, it is the surface of pitch cylinder. Pitch point, It is the point of contact of two pitch circles. Pitch circle. It is an imaginary circle, or we can say a theoretical circle, upon which all the calculations are based. Circular pitch. It is the distance measured on the circumference of pitch circle from a point of one tooth to the corresponding point to the next tooth. It is represented by small p, and the expression is given by small p equals to pi d upon t, where small d is the pitch diameter and capital D is the number of teeth. Diametral pitch. It is the number of teeth per unit length of the pitch circle diameter, given by capital P, and the expression is P equals to T upon D. Module. It is the ratio of pitch diameter to the number of teeth, or we can say it is the reciprocal of diameter pitch. M is given by D upon T. Gear ratio. It is the ratio of number of teeth on gear to that of pinion. It is denoted by capital G, and the expression is G equals to T by T, where capital T is the number of teeth on gear and the small t is the number of teeth on pinion. The bigger gear is known as gear and the smaller gear is known as pinion. Velocity ratio. It is the ratio of angular velocity to the follower to the angular velocity of the driving gear. Omega 2 is the angular velocity of follower and omega 1 is the angular velocity of the driver. In this figure, we can see the circular pitch as defined earlier is starts from this point and ends to the same point on the adjacent tooth. Now, there are various definitions which can be elaborated by this figure. You can see this is the pitch circle, which is we talk about that imaginary or theoretical circle. The top circle drawn is known as addendum circle, which is concentric to the pitch circle. The addendum is the radial distance of tooth from pitch circle to the addendum circle. Similarly, the dedendum circle is the circle drawn through bottom of the teeth and concentric with the pitch circle. And the dedendum is the radial distance of the tooth from pitch circle to the dedendum circle. Clearance. When two gear meshes, then it is the radial distance between top of tooth of one to the bottom of tooth of another. Full depth. Radial distance between addendum circle and dedendum circle is known as full depth. Working depth. The full depth minus clearance is known as working depth. It can also be defined as sum of addendums of two gears. Space width. It is the width of tooth space along the pitch circle. Tooth thickness. It is the thickness of tooth along the pitch circle. Face width. It is the length of tooth parallel to the gear axis. Talk about top length. Then it is the top surface of tooth. Bottom length, it is the bottom surface of the tooth. Face is the surface of tooth above the pitch circle, and flank is the surface of tooth below the pitch circle, including fillets. Fillets are curved surfaces of tooth flank at root circles. The next figure shows the mating of two gears, where the engagement starts from C and ends at D along the line of action. The line of action is a line from the pitch point to the point of contact along which the driving tooth exerts the force on driven tooth. The pressure angle between the pressure angle is defined as angle between pressure line or the line of action to the common tangent of the pitch circle. Path of contact, it is the locus of point of contact of two mating teeth from beginning of engagement to the end of engagement. In this figure, it is defined by CD. It have two parts, path of approach and path of recess. Path of approach is CP, where the beginning of the engagement to the pitch point, and path of recess is PD, from point of contact to the, from pitch point to the disengagement of the matting tooth. Arc of contact is the locus of point on which on a pitch circle of two matting teeth from the beginning of engagement to the end of engagement. For this gear, it is APB, and for this gear, it is EPF. Angle of action, angle turned by the gear from the beginning of engagement to the end of engagement of the pair of teeth. That is denoted by delta, and it is alpha plus beta. Alpha is the angle of path of approach and beta is the angle of path of recess. Contact ratio. It is defined as the ratio of arc of contact to the circular pitch. So this is all about the gear classification and terminology. Thanks for watching.